Have you lost your vim, your vigor, and your pep? Then try ionized yeast to return yourself and restore yourself to your former glory. Ionized yeast, available from apothecaries up and down this sceptered aisle. Can't find a regular source of ionized yeast? Then try reading Occult Detective Magazine. Look at this sad chap. He'd been an acolyte for an evil deity for years, worshipping diligently but getting nowhere. He read just one issue of Occult Detective Magazine and now fights evil the world over. And the fillies love it. Occult Detective Magazine. Available wherever splendid periodicals are sold.
Hello, Pulp Hounds. So I'm here again. I'm in a slightly different wing of Redbeard Towers. I need a bit more space for today's video because I've got a huge and utterly thrilling unboxing to do. Sent to me by Dave Brzeski. I got his name right last time. It's like the first time on a video I've ever got his name right. Dave from Occult Detective Magazine. Got in touch and said, I've got some stuff kicking about, do you want it? And I said, yes, please, that'd be lovely. I also have to say a big thank you to Ian Hunter, who delivered this box of gorgeousness to me. So I've split the top open. I'm in a slightly different bit because I need a bit more space. So I've got space to put stuff there because it's a pretty big box. And I've opened the top and it looks genuinely thrilling inside. So I'm not doing the table setup thing because it's kind of difficult for me to see stuff when I do unboxings and all that with my table setup. I'm kind of looking at it through the camera and the screen. So I just want to be able to have a proper look at these. So without further ado, let's get cracking on this awesome box of what looks to be absolutely amazing stuff. So I'll just dip in and start going. Right off the top, it looks like there's a little pile of kind of retro fanzine stuff. And first up is Shudder Stories number 7. That's what a genius cover. What I think I'll do is I'll do some nice close-up shots of these and cut them in so you can have a proper look. So Shudder Stories number 7 from 1987. What's in this? It looks like it's edited by Robert Price. There's Plaything for the Chortling Fiend by Charles Hoffman. Coffin Crag by Carl Jacoby. Meat for Satan's Icebox, Oh My Word, by Francis James. And another great Hugh B. Cave story by Audrey Parente. Oh my word. Vintage, gorgeous, thoroughly exciting small press fiction magazines. Now I know some of the stuff that's in this because Dave did mention it because some of it's quite big. But he said he just stuck a load more things in and dropped one. But yeah, he said he stuck a load more things in that he had kicking about that he thought I might like. So, oh my word. Tales of Lovecraftian Horror, number 3. Oh, look at that. This is from 1988. Cryptic Publications, edited by Robert Price. What have we got? Willem Pugmire, David Ludwig. Oh, this just looks awesome. Absolutely awesome. It's got some gorgeous illustrations in. And these things are quite expensive to try and get hold of, or quite hard to find in this country. I feel totally spoiled opening this box. Wow. I don't even know what this is. Look at that. Lewd Tales, Robert E. Howard. Okay, I need to have a little look in this. Song of Bastards, Bastards All, and Ancient English Ballad. I do quite like a lot of Robert E. Howard stuff, and I haven't come across those. Oh my word. That's absolutely awesome. Like, to get these kind of old fan fiction, small press magazines, like in the depths of Yorkshire, they're so hard to find. And you, like I said, you can order them online, but at the minute, postage from America is so expensive. It's not even really an option. Postage is like three times the cost of your book. Oh, thank you, Dave. What we got next? There's more of these. These are just beautiful. Shudder Stories, Tales of Degenerate Horror, number 5, from 1986. Again, edited by Robert Price. There's another Carl Jacobi in here. I adore Carl Jacobi, as I've said before. Bride of the Tree Men, there's a Manly Wade Wellman story. Will Murray, I know that name. Oh, these are just gorgeous. Doomed Maidens for Satan's Brothel by Robert M. Price and Charles Garofalo. Just gorgeous, aren't they? They are just, like, brilliant, gorgeous, genius things. Each one is like a little art. Oh, what is this? Okay, so on the front is what looks, it's not, but it looks kind of like almost like an Aubrey Beardsley. And on the back is the drug injection-y cover from Shock Suspense Stories that got me in so much trouble. I need to check this out. Oh, Reefer, there's like adverts for Reefer Madness. It's just like weird adverts and old sleazy comics. Oh my word. That's just awesome. I don't even know what that is, and that needs more research. But that is just a little thing of beauty. I love ephemeral things. Oh my, wow! ...1988 from Charnel House Publishers. Yeah, it's just a tiny little chapbook. But these things just get lost to the mists of time. And I adore them. And they're going to find a treasured place in my library. A wonderful home and a treasured place. What have we got? Ooh, look at that. Eldritch Tales, number 18. What a gorgeous cover. Oh, and there's a brilliant illustration on the back cover. Who's that by? I can't quite read that. It is signed. I'll get my magnifying glass out later on. Oh, and there's a whole huge list of stories inside it. Oh, if I was able to, back in, what year is this from? Let's have a look. 1989. This is exactly what young 1989 me would have absolutely hoovered up and bought with enthusiasm and vigour. Oh. Oh, I've not even got to the things that I knew Dave was sending yet. And I'm just ploughing through these absolutely amazing small press gorgeous books. Next up, Shudder Stories, Tales of Heinous Iniquity. That's genius. I always said, I'm a bit of a Mark Bolan fan. And I always said my autobiography would be called Dandy in the Underworld. But Tales of Heinous Iniquity, I think, is the new title of my autobiography when I do get round to writing it. So what's in this? There's another Carl Jacobi. There's Henry Kuttner. Oh, wow. Randall Larson. These are just going to get read and adored and enjoyed. Look at that cover. That's awesome. That's just beautiful. It's kind of like this small press from the 80s and the, well, 70s and 80s. It's like a cover style that's lost. You know, you look at newer books. You go into Waterstones and you look at the shelves of newer books and they're all like kind of photoshopped. I find a lot of them quite bland. I think that's one of the reasons I like the British Library Tales of the Weird series, because it's a striking illustration. And then you go back to stuff like this. Oh, it just makes my heart sing. What we got here? Oh, no way. Genius. Yeah, I knew this was going to be in here. So, CIBA, Postgraduate Educational Series. This is, if you guys don't watch my vinyl videos, these are 7-inch records with medical lectures on them. And I did a video called The Most Boring Records I Own. And I do quite love them because they're so oddly dull. And what have we got here? We've got The Management of Hypertension and Steroids or ACTH. I am genuinely going to make a cup of tea and listen to those this afternoon. That's awesome. Okay, right. So, there's also another copy of The Angry Dead, because there was a little slight mix-up with the boxes. So, The Angry Dead went to Ian, who dropped this box off. And so, I'm back with my copy of The Angry Dead. I didn't start it. I did film one yesterday, I think. Yeah, I didn't start it this week. And this is going to be on, this is Wednesday's video, but I'm filming it before the weekend because I just wanted to dig into this box. So I'll be starting that tonight, which is Friday. So I might have finished it by Wednesday. We shall see. We shall see. So what? There's more small press. Like chapbooks. I didn't expect any of these, and they are thrilling. Absolutely thrilling and wonderful. What have we got? The Devil's Dictionary by J.N. Williamson. Creepy cliches and sinister synonyms. Oh, that looks ace. And it's illustrated by J.K. Potter, who his illustrations were in the Ramsey Campbell book I spoke about, Alone with the Horrors. Let's find some I'll tell you what, I'll take some photos of the illustrations and put them up on screen, because they are just beautiful. Dewey did illustrations around the same time as Dave Carson, and me and a friend, I bought all the Dave Carson stuff we found, and he bought all the stuff that had J.K. Potter in, so I didn't get much of a look in, so I haven't got a lot of J.K. Potter stuff, but I adore his illustrations. What? Oh my word! Genuinely, Dave, thank you so much. The Arkham Sampler, Volume 3, Number 1. So, the sampler published by Arkham House. What's in this? Thank you so much. These things are like rocking horse shit, genuinely. Like, finding these. Is that Ambrose Bierce on the front? That looks like Ambrose Bierce. The cover shows Ambrose Bierce, it says. Ha ha! Brilliant. There's one, two, and three. Special horror art issue. Three Tales of Terror, adapted and illustrated by William Eman Jr. Oh. These are just amazing. I've got so much to read. There's number three. So much to just thrilling stuff just to sit down, drink tea and read. Who's this? Oh, it's Henry Whitehead, who wrote Jumbie. I've never seen a photo of Henry Whitehead, so that's so cool. Is there a story by Henry Whitehead in? No, there isn't. Oh, there's Phillips Gamwell III. Where do I know that name from? I've got so much like research and fun going through these. And we're not done with the small press stuff yet. How? I can't tell you, Dave, mate. I know you'll be watching this. I cannot tell you how thrilled I am. Next is Dark Dreams. I don't have an issue. Oh, that's so cool. Look at them bad boys. I'd have one of them kicking around my house. Well, I'd have to keep it away from Victor. What kind of stuff's in this? Oh, there's a verse by Ramsey Campbell. Norman Boothroyd, Fiona MacLeod. Oh. And page header, Dave Carson. Look at that. I tell you what, since I got all my lovely Christmas selection of books, the telly's not had a look in. I've watched one short TV series online, Channel 4 one, called The Curse, which is a cool crime thing. I right enjoyed it. I like the big dude that's an ex-boxer. There's nothing that could be on telly that fires my imagination as much as stuff like this. And everyone's like, oh, have you been watching this? At what is it, Session 81 or something? That on Netflix, that everybody's like, you'd love that. I know, but I still haven't got around to watching Game of Thrones yet. Because every time I kind of sit down and I think, I might watch some telly, I just glance round and spot a book that I haven't read or haven't read for a long time. And I'm like, let's have that. It's going to be better than telly. And I think this might be the last small press one. Tales After Dark, September 1986. Tales of the Cthulhu Mythos and Other Nightmare Stories. There's Robert Price stuff, D.F. Lewis, Roger Johnson. There's some Brian Lumley poetry. Oh, and some non-fiction as well. Oh, that's... And look, it's typed. It's not like a printed thing. It's typed. And as you can tell by the new intro for my channel, I am very fond of typewriters. I'm very fond of old technical things anyway that I can faff about with and fix and make work again. Anybody that's been around to my house lately will have spotted a Victorian freestanding gas lamp that is gas powered that I'm trying to get going, genuinely, because I want to read horror stories by actual gaslight on YouTube. So it just being in, and it's actually typed on typewriter. Oh, things like that make me so genuinely happy and thrilled and excited. So I'm going to pause for a sec and have a swig of tea before we get on to the hardbacks. So some of these I know about. First up is, it's got no jacket, but it's the Penguin Book of Horror Stories, which I haven't actually got. And it's a great reading copy. There's some corkers in here. And some I haven't read. There's Two Bottles of Relish by Lord Dunsany, which I've read so many times and it's so good. That looks ace. That looks really ace. So a bit of a reading copy. A lot of these are really nice hardback editions now with gorgeous dust jackets. So what's up next? Chillers for Christmas. I haven't got any Christmas themed anthologies. So there's like Rudyard Kipling, Amelia Edwards, Arthur Conan Doyle, L.P. Hartley, Chetwynd Hayes, The Hanging Tree. Brilliant. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. And it's a gorgeous book. Who published it? Guild Publishing, 1989. Oh, it's a shame it's not Christmas. I can't cope with watching any Christmas specials, really, until Christmas. So I have a little list of things I watch every Christmas, like the Steptoe and Son Christmas specials and the Hancock's Half Hour Christmas specials and the Ghost Stories for Christmas and Trances dry hairs for squids. So that's going to have to be shelved until the next festive season. What we got here? Oh, yes. Lovely. Right, I knew about this one. Tales of Terror and Darkness, Algernon Blackwood. There he is, the man himself. So, I've got all the stories in this. But my hardcovers are creeping up in price. And then the ones that I did have that I read are really, really old Penguin editions, which are creeping up in price. And I wanted a nice omnibus, nice hardback omnibus that I can sit and read. And this is exactly that. It's like an omnibus of the two hardcover collections, Tales of the Uncanny and Supernatural and Tales of the Mysterious and Macabre. I love Algernon Blackwood. That's absolutely thrilling. Right, what's next in this wondrous box? Ooh, that's a nice edition, and it's a chonker. The complete illustrated stories and poems of Edgar Allan Poe. I love Poe. Genuinely love Poe. He was mad as crisps. There's some gorgeous... well, that's the first gorgeous illustration. I'll tell you what, I'll put a photo of it up. Oh, wow. Now, my fondness for Poe is... these illustrations are gorgeous. It was there was a collection of Poe stories. I've spoken about it before. Illustrated by Arthur Rackham. That was the first book I actually spent a decent amount of cash on back in the 80s. I don't think it's worth that much, but it's worth it's priceless to me. And it was, I think it was like £6 back then. And that was like a fair bit. It was a good job I was working on a fruit stall because that means I could afford it. And it's the first kind of really lovely edition I trekked myself to. And I've loved Poe ever since then. There's another Poe, another complete Poe. Oh, that's so lovely. I really like that one. That's gorgeous. Look at him. He's glorious. And then there's a really nice etching of the man himself on the back. There's something about his unpleasant madness and the fact that not everything was... supernatural. There was a lot to do with science and obsession and misery, and I've got a nice little collection of, it's normally the complete or the selected best of Poe. I've got a nice little collection of like Poe editions, and these two will go very lovely in that collection. Oh, this looks nice. Oh, brilliant. Look at that. 100 Ghastly Little Ghost Stories. It's a rate chonker as well. Oh, so the text is going to be a bit bigger, I think. Let's have a look. Oh, yeah, it is. That's fab. So. Oh, there is Henry Whitehead, Dorothy Quick, R.H. Benson, Joseph Sheridan, Lee Fanu. There's so... Oh. There's just like pages and pages and pages of contents. Short ghost stories. Now, like I said, there's not much. My telly's behind me. That's why I'm pointing that way. There's not that much on telly. I'd rather read a story. And having like stories of different lengths, from really quite short up to big chunky novels, I kind of read about four or five books at once. I normally read the standard novel that I'm ploughing through, but I don't like leaving a chapter half finished. I like to stop at the end of a chapter. So if I don't think I've got time to read a full chapter, this will stay on my little coffee table and I will just pick it up and read a very quick wondrous ghost story. That's just awesome. Now, these are creeping up a bit in price. I had a little look at them last night because these are ones that I haven't actually got around to picking up. And it's the St. Michael ones. So for our transatlantic chums or any friends watching in Australia, St. Michael, I don't know if you have St. Michael there, it was part of Marks and Spencer, the kind of posh clothes and food shop that you would never go for your main shop. You would only go for your bits. I've never been able to afford it. I'm more of a Fulton's kind of guy. If you're a Fulton's person and you shop at Fulton's a lot, like I do, I play a really fun game. Why is it in Fulton's? Because sometimes you get really good stuff in Fulton's, and sometimes you get really good stuff that looks really good but tastes like the inside of a false leg. So it's kind of like, oh, that looks great, I love that. And then you get it home and you're like, Jesus, this is horrid. So if you do shop at Fulton's, play the why is it so cheap in Fulton's game. Sometimes you'll be surprised that, and it's really good, and sometimes it's grim, but it adds a little bit of lively fun to your meal times. Anyway, yeah, 65 great spine chillers, edited by the wonderful Mary Danby. Let's have a little look who's in this. Elizabeth Bowen, Ramsey Campbell, Chetwynd Hayes, Sir Winston Churchill, Arthur Conan Doyle. It's just a plethora of wonderful stories. Stephen Grendon, the Santa in the Parlour. I've read that somewhere. That's just triggered a memory. That's what set me off being interested. If you don't know, I don't want to be like culturally inappropriate, but a Santa is a shrunken head from the Jivaro tribe. Was it Bertrand Fornoy wrote a brilliant book called Jivaro that you should check out if you're interested in that. It's quite anthropologically interesting, but it's also got like a kind of ghoulish edge, like, oh, look at these shrunken heads. And I've just been a fan of shrunken heads ever since then. I think that out of this entire box, that is what I'm reading first, and I'm going to skip ahead to the Santa in the Parlour. So we've got another St. Michael one. I was looking at this last night, and you can't, with postage, you can't get it for about less than a tenner now. And that's 65 great tales of horror. I love that hairy, wary wolf on the front. Look at him. He's ace. Another Mary Danby anthology. So they were published, I think, like, St. Michael was the, almost like, obviously that was the kind of supermarket, even though it's posher than a supermarket, that sold it. But they're actually published by, is it Sundial? Yeah. So they're published by Sundial, but I think they were sold exclusively in Marks and Spencer's. So, again, Hans Heinz Ewers, The Spider. Oh, that's so good. Henry James, The Romance of Certain Old Clothes. I find old clothes quite romantic. Yes. Francis Stevens, Claws. Oh, I. Because I read that, like, on my channel the other week. Brilliant, 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 brilliant. Oh. So looking, I've just never got round to picking these St. Michael ones up, and they make a gorgeous set. And lastly, in the box is another St. Michael one, 65 Great Tales of the Supernatural. So, not quite as brilliant-y cover. Again, published by Sundial and sold through Marks and Spencer's. So E.F. Benson, oh, the bus conductor, Robert Aitman ringing the changes. Oh, Amelia Edwards, which William Hope Hodgson is it? The Whistling Room, brilliant, 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 brilliant. Oh, Gerald Kirsch, Carnival on the Downs, Nigel Neal, Minook. I think I've read that one. I mean, like, as a Sunday story. Oh, so, and that's it. I'm not saying like that's it, like, oh, that's it. That's it as in, that's everything that's in the box, every single joyous, wonderful item. Thank you so much, Dave. I genuinely appreciate it. Like, really, truly appreciate it. So, if you want to check out Occult Detective Magazine, obviously, this isn't a sponsored thing. I just think it's a brilliant and fun fiction magazine that's actually very high quality. And the paper editions are beautiful. I think they're worth getting the paper editions if you can. It's not like I'm sponsored, and I'm not just saying it because the editor, or one of the editors, lovely Dave, sent me all these gorgeous, gorgeous things. I am saying it because genuinely I think it's a brilliant magazine. So yeah, check it out. I'll put an Amazon link in the description for the new issue. I think there's paper editions left, and there's PDFs. So thank you for watching, you lovely lot. I'm quite busy this weekend, which is going to be a struggle, but I'm actually going to go, literally put my camera away and edit this another day, because I just wanted to go through this box. And now I want to sit for the rest of the night with Victor on my lap reading horrible, horrible stories. That sounds like a perfect evening. Thank you for watching, you lot.